introduction, you will learn the benefits of using a power management system. Vessels today may have a number of generator sets, split bus bars, and a variable load. Automatic control of all these has become common practice to ensure continuity of service and an efficient management of both generating and load equipment. Typical power management system will incorporate the following functions: automatic line frequency adjustment, load monitoring, load dependent start-stop of generator sets, supervision of heavy consumer switch-on, load sharing, automatic start and connect after blackout. Other functions which may be controlled by the power management system include control of the pre-lubrication pumps on the standby diesels, automatic load-dependent change of fuel on larger auxiliary diesels, diesel to HFO and vice versa. Click on item to have that item described to you in greater detail. The power management system sends increase-decrease signals to the governor. Without the power management system, fine adjustments of the frequency has to be executed manually by means of the up-down switches on the main switchboard. The total system load is monitored and compared with the available online generating capacity. The systems will advise the operator to start or stop the generator sets. In auto mode, this will be carried out automatically. The total system load is monitored and compared with the available online generating capacity. The system will advise the operator to start, stop the generator sets in response to varying load. In auto mode, this will be carried out automatically. The power management system will consider the total load in relation to the available online capacity before allowing the heavy consumer to start. This is done to prevent blackout. If the actual load and the heavy consumer load total is greater than the available online capacity, the power management system will start and connect the next generator before the heavy consumer is allowed to be switched on. The blackout logic is triggered when the power management system reads 0 volts on the main bus bars. The highest priority generator will attempt to start and connect to the main bus bars. If this fails, the next diesel generator will try to start and connect. Move the cursor over the different push buttons and indicators for a description. Let us assume that one generator is connected and the other one is ready. Both generators are in auto and are set to equal load sharing. You can now increase and decrease the load on the generators and change from equal load to optimal load. When finished, press the continue button. By now, it should be obvious that to achieve maximum safety during manoeuvring, both generators should be connected and equal load sharing selected as the control mode. Note that even if the principle is the same, there are several types of power management systems found on the market, so you must always familiarise yourself with the actual system found on board your ship.